Would you believe there's a free tool from Google that tells you what's trending, what's popular, and gives you ideas on how you can get into the conversation and win new customers? You ready to check it out? Here we go. My friends, welcome to Google Trends. Google Trends is a free web-based tool. You can access it on desktop, laptop, smartphone, or tablet. You have to be signed into your Google account. So if you don't have an account, you're going to want to create one. Today, I'm going to assume that you're signed into your Google account. And once you are, you can start using this tool. So here is where we're actually going to be checking out what's trending, what's a hot topic right now in the eyes of Google. And Google is providing this information based off of searches. So let's say that we're going to be starting a pizza place. Right? Or maybe we have a restaurant, an Italian restaurant. We're trying to figure out what kind of pizza we want to add to the menu because we just got this brand new brick oven. So I'm going to start with thin crust pizza. I'll choose that. So now what's happening is Google is going to show me, based on search, based on what it's seeing with people searching related to thin crust pizza, it's going to show me the relative popularity. Okay. So from 0, meaning not popular, to 100, meaning this is popular, we see that, hey, over the past 12 months in the US, thin crust pizza has been pretty popular. Then it took a dip down in October, and now it's at about 58%. So let's say 6 out of 10 people are searching for thin crust pizza. Okay, but I might not offer thin crust pizza. What if I want to offer thick crust pizza? Okay, thick crust pizza in this case, people aren't really searching for. It's not very popular compared to thin crust. Well, I did this on purpose because usually it's called pan pizza. If we look for pan pizza, we can see that pan pizza is actually even more popular than thin crust pizza. So what I just did is I kind of tested out, and the beautiful thing about Google Trends is you can test out different search terms and see what's trending, what's popular. In this case, I know that pan pizza is popular, thick crust people aren't searching for. I'm going to remove that. So now I've got thin crust versus thick crust. But let's add in a third competitor. What about gluten-free pizza? Uh-huh. So when we add in the idea of gluten-free pizza, because a lot of folks are living a gluten-free lifestyle or they've been diagnosed with celiac and have to remove gluten from their diet. Now, if I'm a pizza place, if I'm a proprietor of a pizza restaurant or Italian restaurant, I want to offer menu items that are going to bring in more diners. Well, let's look at what Google Trends tells us. Okay, so now we have thin crust pizza versus pan pizza versus gluten-free pizza. And again, we're trying to make this decision of what menu item we want to add to our menu to win new customers. Well, right away, I can cancel out thin crust pizza. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to delete that one. Now, for those of you that are thin crust pizza fans, I get it. But in this case, it's not going to help us because Google's telling us this isn't trending. People aren't searching for this in relation to the other search terms you've entered. Google Trends has told me that in the kind of battle of the pizzas, gluten-free pizza is more popular in relation to pan pizza. Now, I could offer both on my menu if I wanted to. I mean, it shows that they're pretty kind of neck and neck for the most part. Or if I'm going to just go with one, then I might choose gluten-free because it's usually on top of pan pizza. But what would I do with this? How would I actually start using what I've learned in Google Trends to inform my content plan or my marketing plan? Well, in this case, gluten-free pizza is going to be the search term that I base my marketing and my content around. I might build a new web page dedicated to gluten-free pizza. I might make a video on YouTube that talks about how we create gluten-free pizza. We have a dedicated gluten-free workspace in our kitchen so that there's no cross-contamination. People won't get sick. I might create blog posts, or I might start using social media, posting up on Facebook, TikTok, Instagram, Twitter. I might also send out email campaigns announcing our new gluten-free pizza. Why? Because Google Trends is telling me that it's popular. I want to get in on the conversation And all those different channels that I just listed are ways that you can. Now, in the next video, in the next tool that I show you, I'm not only going to show you that these terms are popular, I'm going to actually give you some data behind it so you can figure out how many people are searching each month and also get new keyword ideas or opportunities based off the tool. Until then, stay well, stay healthy, stay happy. Here's to your success.